I know you're out there. I can feel you now. I know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. I don't know the future. I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how it's going to begin. I'm going to hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.
Evil is real. Fear is its tool, its weapon, their only defense. Those who follow evil have no soul. They're part of the hive mind, focused on creating misery everywhere. We live in a world where watching all the Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, Marvel, or just playing a game from start to finish in one sitting is somehow tasking, or more often, a challenge. Something tries to convince us to give up on what we love and that loves us, while forcing us to refuse to see that there are things we love that sadly do not love us and will only use us, abuse us, or worse. I have seen both in my life and the lives of others the pattern of abuse, a cycle that must be broken. See, there are two groups here, as far as I know it. The good, who focus on love, joy, and only want peace and to simply party on. Then there is evil, who cannot feel love or joy, refuse to learn how, and simply want to destroy the fun for the rest of us. Because they are too stubborn to try something new, or perhaps more truthfully, for the true evil. They would never want a world of love and peace. They only want destruction and suffering. We have no use for that kind of thing. We have no use for supposed family who make us feel unloved and uncared for. No matter how much we value something, if it abuses us by making us feel horrible, while we do our best to make them feel good, and our only wish, our only desire is to be seen, heard, and loved, then that thing that refuses to give us which we give it is not just unnatural, but evil, and does not deserve our wonderfulness. To destroy evil, we must destroy its heart. We must break it. They need our suffering, our attention. They require us to give in, to feed off our energy. Well, we can refuse to give in. We can fight back. This is a battle of will. It's not about causing physical harm. After all, is the harm we endure mostly physical or within us? Fighting back is not about stabbing them in the heart. It's about breaking the heart. I have done so. And while it took a toll, while my health was attacked, while I was terrified, confused, and miserable, all I focused on was the love I felt. I knew I just had to keep on keeping on. I had to trust in the process, to have faith in myself, to be proud of myself, to realize that insanity would be dipping my toes in and never fully embracing the ideals, feelings, and beliefs that were guiding, protecting, shaping, and nurturing me. I also knew I had enough real, factual evidence to know there was much of a chance that this was all real as anything else. All I had to do was realize, I wanted this. This is awesome. I'm stronger than evil. I faced down fear and whooped its little bitch ass. Like, fuck me, right? This little nobody, this little weakling, this little lazy motherfucker somehow has more will than I, or anything other than my guardians, my spiritual Ohana, knew. Now, I look to the horizon and realize I never had a future. None of us did. Until now.
Have you ever thought what there is beyond the borders of our city?
This is the head of the security department speaking. To keep citizens safe from a terrible disease, the borders of the city have been closed.
In the violence caused such silence, who are we mistaking? But you see, it's not me, it's not my family. In your head, they are fighting.
They walk around in masks. But who are they really? Dad could be one of them.
There is no epidemic, no infection. All this is just a cover for the authorities to justify taking away anyone with a gift. This gift, it has awakened in you.
I'm not staying here. I will find him.
See your head, in your head.